The making of a 15th century tap. In the first part, you saw how I made the model for this tap. In this part, you will see the mold making, the casting, the demolding, as well as the fettling of the raw cast. The wax model is invested in molding clay. Molding clay actually has much more in common with loam than with clay, which is why it should be rather called molding loam. Clay is too fat and would, due to its shrinkage, result in a cracked mold. Molding material is thus made leaner by adding grog or temper. The temper here is a recycling material made from used old mold fragments. Horse manure is added as an organic temper. In the loam's green state, it improves its plastic capabilities and, equally important, in its fired state, it leaves innumerable cavities behind which greatly improve the mold material's gas permeability. Before casting, the green mold needs to be dried and fired. During the firing process, the wax melts away and thus turns the lump of mud into a mold. The metal was cast at approximately 1120 degrees Celsius. The alloy is a low zinc brass with some 22% zinc. After a short cooling period, the molds can be taken and cooled down in water. As prolonged cooling times will result in a coarse grain structure, which I am not particularly fond of. As we can see, the molds withstood the firing and casting without any major damage. Now let's inflict some and crack open the mold. After breaking away the mold, we can see a number of flashes or fins, which are the result of some smaller cracks in the mold. These metal projections are no major problem and can be chiseled away rather effortlessly. Fettling of the raw cast includes removing any excess material, such as fins, flashes or air bubbles, as well as the downsprue and vents. this concludes part 2, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next installment. The third part will show the filing, fitting and finishing of the tap. If you do like what you see here, consider liking and subscribing.